here we are in the third video of our unique survival, surviving the PSN outage. So, you know, I'm glad you've stuck with us. So the voice you're hearing right now is Mumra. I'm Mumra.
Hey there, guys. This is Scottish Mark.
Oh, hey. This is X Horizon. It's my turn. Hey.
I think it's my turn next. I'm Paul. I'm Nikaru.
And lastly, I'm Drew the Bear.
All right, so there's six of us, and we're gonna survive the next video together. So, gentlemen, are you ready?
Start your engines.
Right, okay, two, one. All right, it's FreeBattle Stats match.
Yeah.
Stats are on.
Actually, I've got a question for you. Actually, for everyone, how often do you actually play music while you're in survival mode?
Never.
When I'm Snake, I've got I play music, but I've got it in a way that I don't hear it because my settings.
Yeah.
The music is on.
Oh, wow.
Shit! You five of them.
Yeah, I shouldn't have gone down there.
Oh, you did. Oh.
Do you know what? You see that that Ninja MGS guy? He's meant to be pretty good. This is a pretty.
I think he's from NA. He's very laggy, but he is good.
Yeah, yeah. He's meant to be quite the headshot out there, quite the name. So shit. What was it? Yeah. So on my. I wish I could have music volume set to zero.
Oh, that's nice. That's pro.
Nice.
I wish I got that last guy, though.
Mm.
Damn. But yeah, I wish I could set it on... So my sound settings is like 10, 10, 10, 1. Because I wish I could have it on zero, because I hate the, you know, the music when in snake mode. But I always set the music to being like the drum and bass track on snake.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, I've always found, like, sometimes in a team deathmatch, hearing some kind of vibrant music always sometimes pumps me up. I don't know why, I can't explain it, but sometimes you hear just, like, some decent music and it makes you want to take a risk almost.
Oh, yeah, that's
really
that's the Harry Gregory Williams effect, you know?
Ooh, fancy.
Thing is, hearing is so underrated in MGO.
Oh, yeah.
I do, like, 50% of my orientation and kills I get through hearing.
Headset.
I'm really not kidding. So in team sneaking... I can, if I camp the target when defending, I can really hear the guys approaching the target.
Mm.
Yeah,
and I'm like, footsteps. Oh, hey, I hear footsteps, and my guys in the team are like, no, I can't hear crap. But I know they're there.
Yep, that's right. I mean, like, how many of you can testify that, how much did your gameplay improve the moment you got yourself a headset? Even a stereo headset at that.
Yeah.
The thing is, Mumra, ever since I'm into online gaming, I've always... been paying attention to sounds, so it's nothing new to me.
Well, you're a musician as well, so I imagine that will make a difference as well. Like that guy I just named, I knew he was there because of the headset. It's like I heard the footsteps coming down the stairs.
Yeah.
I
look down. Free fire.
That's right.
Nice.
The teamwork. See.
Yeah.
Free the man. Free him up. You got to free the man up. Don't let him sit there vulnerable when he's seeing. He already. So long as. Wait for him to scan.
I remember
then move
you
on.
Screaming to me in like survival. It's like stun him.
Yeah,
stun him.
Take it. Like, because when I've got someone in a CQC chokehold, I'm vulnerable. I want to drop this motherfucker. I've already stabbed him with my dirty needle. And then
that sounds so bad. Sorry.
I want to move on.
With his needle. Oh, what do you mean, Nikuru?
Sounds like something out of Trainspotter.
Maybe not. Maybe needle sounds better than magic rainbow stick.
No, that sounds a lot better.
Maybe in your fairy tale world.
Oh, I can't believe I'm still using 5 on this, but I'm not doing too badly.
Mumra, you still got the MK2 to run with. Did you notice that it actually slows you down a tiny...
Really? Wait, the MK2 is slower than the knife? Makes you slower than the...
I think a tiny little bit.
Oh, I'll have to...
A grenade or a knife is really giving you a speed boost.
I will have to test that theory later, sir.
But I thought...
Yeah,
when PSN is out. Actually slow you down slightly.
Wow. Well,
but yeah, just compared to this...
It makes kind of sense. But maybe not.
Oh, nice move.
That's the thing.
Respawn.
Exactly. You see, I'm glad you saw what I tried to do there, but I messed up. I should have just... Maybe because of where that base is, maybe I should have secured killing him first.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know. Because that, you know, was the first thing I thought, like, shit, get on that base, make sure no one respawns, and hopefully by the time his animation tries to get back up, I'll have the base back.
Yeah, that's always a bit of a tricky situation. If a grenade comes in and the guy rolls away last second, you never know where they're going to appear again. So this gets me killed many times, actually, because I fire into the wrong direction and then I get a headshot from behind.
Oh, yeah. The joys of MGO.
Yeah, gotta love it or hate it. Well, you can't take that base because it takes...
I know, but the thing is, though, you get points.
Yeah, you get little points.
That's true. Sitting on it.
Yeah.
But usually one guy takes 20 seconds to take a base, two guys take it 10 seconds.
Yeah. And you win. All because of you.
Oh, nice. Sitting on top. Laughing.
I'll tell you, a really underrated weapon in base is a chaff grenade. Like, whenever I play, I always allocate someone to, you know, use them. Because like, it's an absolute lifesaver.
I think it's only really the most useful when you're losing,
or especially when you're in their half of their, like, you know, their side of the map. As well.
Personally, I think it's only worth using when you're losing. Personally, because you want to be able to defend what you've got is more important than trying to get all of them. And so the chaff when you're losing is like, well, now you motherfuckers, you know, you try to get a bit more of an advantage because they then, you know. Won't.
Like an act out of despair.
Yeah. But it's our comebacks are that's what many of my comebacks have been based upon in base. Mm. I'll throw that chaff, and all you need to do is get that one extra base, and then you're back in the game. It's when no one's chaffing, and you're just trying to defend that one base still that you just lose the game, and the other team are racking up the points from keeping you, you know, boxed in. Like, say, for instance,
on big maps, but on smaller maps versus a good team, they
like,
mostly
can say, for instance, let's say MM. Let's say you're spawning on the end where your team's sneaking, right? And you know that first base. Let's say that's like the base.
You mean five?
Yeah, five.
Yeah, five.
And that's like the last base that's the base you've got. If no one sends a chaff and you get people trying to sneak to one or two, or, you know, the ones on the side, you know which ones, in the alleys.
In the alleyway,
yeah.
Base three. Yeah.
Base three. Yeah. Then, you know, all it takes is, like, the moment they see that start to flash, it's like, oh, what's that guy doing there? They respawn on flipping, you know, that middle base and then take you out, and then it's back to business. So yeah, if you've got a chaff, you might still get it.
So, that's true.
Yeah, so that's my... I shouldn't really be divulging this, though, should I? But no one listens. No one watches my videos anyway. So
yeah.
Yeah, they're all busy watching DS. The real pros, DS and Merkin and M-Stick
and Rebecca Black videos.
Rebecca Black.
Yeah.
There we go.
All right. Okay. Let's get. You ready for the next one, guys?
Ready.
Go get a drink.
Go for it.
All right. Right. Everyone, say goodbye.
See you later, guys.
Hey, door in Swedish.
Theodore. Theodore's goodbye in Swedish?
No, I say hey door.
Theodore.
Doesn't that mean
oh, that's what you like. Ah, see you later. Theodore.
Bye-bye.